Sri Vivek Gupta, your party time is 6 minutes. Sir, thank you for giving me an opportunity to speak here today. Sir, I was just recalling the last occasion I had when I spoke on this bill. And for that, sir, I would like to refer to a document, which is the Statement of Objects and Reasons. Sir, it reads, amendments of the Act were carried out through the Companies Amendment Act 2015 to address the immediate difficulties arising out of the initial experience of the working of the Act and to facilitate, inverted commas, sir, ease of doing business. During the consideration of the Companies Amendment Bill 2015 in the Rajya Sabha, this is where I come in, sir, I had also raised this, views were expressed that more amendments would be required. Sir, as Companies Law Committee of the committee was therefore constituted, constituting of representatives from various sections. Sir, history is repeating itself. I had said this in 2015 and I am forced to repeat it again today, that again this bill is inconclusive. It is not going to address all the issues and concerns that are faced by the Indian industry or corporates or SMEs. And we are again going to take the house of, take the time of the House of Parliament and again bring up another bill in 1 or 2 years. So this is not my prediction, this is the reality. I hope the Honorable Minister considers this and takes some corrective action. Sir, recently one of the speakers before myself said, used the word government office ke chakkar lagane padte hain. Sir, I completely agree with that. But sir, none of the provisions of this bill solve any of those problems. Sir, I would invite the Honorable Minister through you to at least visit the various registrar of company offices, make it a surprise visit. Just see what the conditions are. Why are there so much of crowd there? Why are so many company people, company secretaries standing there getting their issues resolved? When the entire system is computerized, when every filing is online, why people still have to go there? And you know how the system works in India. Sir, I don't want to repeat, but I am forced to repeat certain things. Sir, some changes are little threatening or little frightful to me. Sir, the removing of object clause, sir, the various Supreme Court judgments and the Income Tax Act at various places refers that the specific exemption is available only if that is mentioned in the object clause. Now, sir, I don't know how the government plans to harmonize these, because this will become a future problem. Sir, this private placement, sir, at one end the government says 2 lakh companies are being removed, dormant companies, we are want money laundering, we want to get tough on money laundering, and at the same time they are trying to make money laundering much more easier if these kind of restrictions are removed. Sir, this is a conflict in one arm of the government and the other arm of the government. I don't know how they propose to, same is the case with forward dealing, layers of subsidies. Sir, all of this is in complete contradiction to what the government says in other places. Sir, one interesting aspect of this bill, which was not mentioned by anyone, and I thought it probably escaped the attention of the minister, here, is for providing deposit insurance. So through this bill, the provision for giving deposit insurance has been done away with. Sir, already we are having, the whole nation is in an outcry on the FRDI bill with the bail-in provision, where my fixed deposit with the bank can be used to repay the bank's liabilities. And now, sir, company deposits are also not going to be safe. Are we going to tell the people of India that you should not deposit, you should not take fixed deposits with either companies or banks? Sir, I think this is a very, very serious thing and the minister should take note of it and give a proper answer. Sir, loans to directors, 185. Sir, I need not name, but there was a former member of this house who is no longer a member of this house and who is no longer in this country. And the Honorable Prime Minister made an announcement that a special law will be made to bring him back and bring all the money that he has taken away. Sir, I think this 185 will make it easier for him to, or people like him who have such intentions, to not only take money out of this country, but take money out of companies also, which is the public's money. Sir, our Honorable ex-Finance Minister, Chidambaram ji, when he said about SME, I completely agree with him and I want to echo him, that 40% of the GDP is being provided by SME. However, sir, this formula one size fits all, or one shoe, or one size can, one law can cater to everybody. Sir, it's an experiment that has already failed. So we would request the Honorable Minister to consider that as a lot of the sections of the Act are so draconian, it is impossible for small and medium enterprise to comply. So what do we expect out of our small and medium companies? Whether they should do make in India or should they just end up do compliance, which is not applicable for them. Sir, an interesting issue is the Companies Law Committee have made a lot of recommendations. Some of them have not been approved. We would like to know from the Honorable Minister in his reply why they were not approved. But one of them, I need to bring it to your notice, sir, that earlier a resident of India, the definition of a resident of India was that he has to be resident for 12 months. Now that definition is being done away with. So now anyone can just fly in, become a director from day one, and we would not know whether what connection he has with India, and if we are to ever, you know, lay our hands on him, he would see going back to his country because the law of this land would not be applicable to him. Sir, the new insolvency ordinance is also a case in point. Wherever we are trying to define relatives and we are related companies, sir, one minute. So I'll conclude in 1 minute. Whenever we are trying to define relatives and everything, sir, it has been made in such a manner that no companies can bid. So what this corporate shareholder, the word corporate shareholder is appearing in so many sections and it has got so confusion. I would like the Honorable Minister to give some clarity on it and if possible, make those amendments in this bill itself. So last but not the least, sir, this bill again fails to address the differences with various other government bills, RBI Act, SEBI Act and Income Tax Act. I had proposed previously also, and again, once again, through you, I want to propose to the minister, like issues like depreciation. It is different in this act, it is different in the Income Tax Act. Similarly, there are other places with the RBI, the SEBI Act and the companies that do not agree with each other to remove such differences and give us one clarity. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Now, next is Harivansh. Your party's time is...